Tonight's bouts is sanctioned by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. Commissioners at ringside, Joel Frank and Rudy Battle. Our executive director is Greg Serb. Physicians at ringside, Dr. George Stolsteimer, Dr. Bert Blackstone, and Dr. Paul Steinberg. And our timekeeper at the bell, Jim Mina. Boxing fans, here we go. Our co-main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing in the middleweight division. Our judges, Pierre Benoist, David Braslow, John Potteray, and our co-main event referee, Gary Rosado. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he comes to us tonight from the beautiful Nassau in the Bahamas. He weighed in at 162 pounds, black trunks, aqua trim. Professional record, a perfect 14 victories, no defeats, 10 of his wins coming by knockout. Please welcome former Olympian, Tureano Reno Johnson. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he comes to us tonight from Brownsville, Brooklyn, New York. He weighed in at 162 and three quarter pounds. Black, blue, red trunks, professional record, 26 victories, only four defeats, 19 of his wins by knockout. Please welcome Curtis Showtime Stevens. Our referee, Gary Rosado, has our fighters' final instructions.
Detail instructions in the locker morning, I tell you two things. Protect yourselves at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves, bang at the bell. All
right. 10 rounds. Middleweights.
Stevens trying to get in the head of Johnson. A little touch of the gloves there, but no look into the eyes. We'll see if he can get in close to Johnson. And Johnson, how legit is this power? 10 of his 14 wins coming by way of knockout, 7 of those in the first two rounds.
I don't think it's a question of the power of Johnson. And you see Johnson comes out in southpaw stance. Look at that right there. Nice start. And he's got to be careful not to get in the wheelhouse of Curtis Stevens too early. Good
and
shots
Johnson's
by Johnson.
Coming right at him, trying to work the body of Stevens. Johnson said he was going to do this. He's living up to it right now, said he had no fear.
The wrong strategy for Johnson here. He looks very tight, very compact on the inside, but this is the wrong strategy for Johnson, I'm telling you.
Few men have tried this in the early going. Johnson is trying to go toe-to-toe with Stevens.
Makes for an entertaining fight that won't last, Kenny. I don't think this one's going too long.
Well, the southpaw Johnson, his biggest pro fight. And he has taken it to Curtis Stevens. Let's check in with Chris.
Andre, Johnson's coming right at him. Is this what you want to see?
Actually, yeah, because eventually he'll touch him enough to get him out of there.
How's Curtis's condition coming to this fight? Only fought one round in his last one.
Oh, he's ready to work. He's ready to work.
Thanks, Andre.
Nice short right uppercut inside by Johnson. And Stevens a little surprised that Johnson came at him like this. He really is. And Johnson's defense, very compact. He's got him nice and tight on the ropes, keeping everything in close. Curtis caught him with a couple nice hooks, but Johnson's still there, Kenny.
Johnson with that great amateur experience. Stevens with good amateur experience himself. He has the third most knockouts in New York amateur history. Power punches landed so far, and they have been landed frequently.
Nice left hook by Stevens there.
Stevens now counters, going to the body.
And Johnson's got to move his head if he's going to sit inside with Curtis like that. Curtis also has a very good right uppercut. You see it right there, digging that into the body. That could be a very effective punch.
Oh, good lefts by Curtis Stevens in close.
And I'm very surprised that Johnson decided to come right out and take Curtis Stevens to the ropes like that. He puts himself in danger, but he's also landing some decent shots in there, Kenny. Nice right uppercut by Johnson.
Slides in two uppercuts. Tureano Tureano. Johnson said he was ready to bring it. It depended on the kind of fighter who could fight in close. So far, so good for him. Over 2 minutes into this fight.
Johnson's back into the orthodox stance now. He came out southpaw, though. And look at him trying to take the fight to Curtis, really walking him down, using good head movement. Curtis very relaxed against the ropes there, shooting good punches, catching a lot of the Johnson punches on his gloves. But Johnson's done some good work, Kenny. Very surprising.
BJ, southpaw or orthodox, has been an aggressive Tureano Johnson here in this first round.
And he's got nice, short, compact punches in there, Kenny. That's the thing that's saving him. He's able to match Curtis Stevens punch for punch because he's not wasting a lot of energy and he's not wasting a lot of space on those punches. They're not looping punches. They're nice and short. Big left hook by Stevens.
Johnson is able to get through the first round and look good doing so. You can join in on the action at home on Twitter for a chance to win prizes from tonight's fight. Just follow at NBCSN on Twitter. Well, it was an interesting first round. Tureano Johnson in the black with the turquoise trim coming right at Curtis Stevens, and he's doing the same here as we start round two.
Johnson
Larry
landed.
Hazard is unofficially scoring it for us, and he gave that first round.
And Johnson comes right back out in the second round trying to apply more pressure. He's still got to be careful. Curtis Stevens has a very heavy left hand, and when he's in that southpaw stance, he's very vulnerable to that left hook in close. So got to be careful, but so far you got to see, like what you've seen out of the corner of Johnson.
Well, Johnson charged out the start of this fight showing southpaw, went back to orthodox, and continues to walk right at Curtis Stevens. Let's check in with Chris Mannix.
Antonio, Tureano promised yesterday he would come right out and stand and trade with Curtis. He's doing that so far. Why is that a good strategy for you guys?
Because he's in tip-top shape, and I made sure he was prepared to go to war.
He's trading shots with Curtis right now. Are you worried at all about his chin?
It's going to break him down. It's a matter of time. You're going to be surprised. He's going to stop Curtis. Give him by the seventh round.
Thanks, Tony.
Nice left hook by Curtis Stevens on the inside. You see, he's pretty patient. Oh, beautiful uppercut as well.
Beautiful uppercut indeed by Stevens.
And with Stevens, he's got that one-punch equalizer. He's got that power. Once he gets calmed down and relaxed, he can change the fight or end the fight at any time. So Johnson's doing well in this round. Yes, he won the last round, but Curtis has that one-punch power. And, you know, Johnson has to continue to be careful on those ropes. Keep his head off the center, not in the way of the Curtis Stevens uppercut.
Johnson landing more of the power punches in the early going of this round as he did in the first round. Trying to get an uppercut of his own and not able to. Remember, Johnson said at the fighter meeting yesterday, I'm not afraid of an early knockout. He said, actually, all this first-round knockout stuff about Stevens is, quote, a myth. It depends on who fights him and do they know how to fight him. So far, he knows how to fight him.
Johnson is smothering him. He's taking away some of the advantage of Curtis Stevens. And it's surprising that he's trying to physically bully Curtis Stevens inside a little bit. He's pushing him back. He's making Curtis Stevens fight his fight. And who would have thought this would be Johnson's fight, Kenny?
Johnson has turned into Curtis Stevens right now.
He really has. And, you know, the thing that he's doing so well is he's making Curtis uncomfortable. He's hitting Curtis in the body. He's hitting him with shots. I think Curtis expected to be in full control at this stage in the fight and Johnson to be on the retreat.
Johnson continues to be active. Nice right as he slides it over the glove.
Big right hand by Johnson inside.
Right again by Johnson. Johnson showing his own power here in the first two rounds.
And it's hard for Curtis to be too offensive with both feet square together. He needs to get one foot in front of the other one so he can get good leverage on his punches. Very difficult round for Curtis Stevens again.
Final seconds, round two.
Where do I want you to stay? Why are you on the road today?
Yo, Kurt.
Can't catch that. No, oh, don't try to catch this work. It'll come.
Andre Rozier in the corner of Curtis Stevens between rounds. Stevens a little bit surprised and confused, perhaps, that Tureano Johnson, the undefeated young pro from the Bahamas, has taken the fight to him in the first two rounds.
Kenny, I'm confused. I'm shocked that he came out like that and he's able to bully him in the ropes like that. The corner of Stevens is saying, hey, get in the middle of the ring. But Johnson is cutting it off very effectively, and more of the same from Curtis.
Stevens now trying to work back.
Big left hook by Stevens, but Johnson undeterred. Johnson's zone. He's very rough.
Body shot by Johnson.
And big right uppercut counter. Beautiful shot by Curtis Stevens with his back on the ropes right there.
These two guys, neither backing down.
Curtis has got to be careful not to give away too many of those body shots early, Kenny. This is the second or third round, and the corner of Stevens is already saying, you're giving away too many body shots. That'll wear him down the stretch.
And coming back to the body again is Tureano Johnson. Larry Hazard giving
Johnson on the inside. Beautiful punch selection inside. You know, when you're in that close, it doesn't look like there's a lot of punches you can land. But Toriano's picking the punches that he can land, and he's got Stevens a little bit of trouble here, Kenny.
He slid a nice uppercut in just a few moments ago. Uppercut by Johnson.
I can't believe the pace of Johnson here. He's pretending like this is a four-round fight.
Johnson has been at a frenetic pace since the start of this fight.
And now Curtis switched the momentum a little bit. He's back in Toriano into the ropes. And hopefully he'll go back into the middle of the ring here. Nice short left uppercut
again.
Nice counter left uppercut by Curtis Stevens.
Stevens coming back on Johnson, but Johnson continues to actually be more aggressive in this third round, BJ. He is not slowing down.
He's not. We saw him very confident in the fighter meetings yesterday, Kenny, and now we see why. Good punch by Curtis Stevens, and Curtis starting to loosen up now with his back against the ropes. Johnson's got to be very careful to get his head off the center when he's inside with Curtis Stevens, because Curtis Stevens got that very effective right uppercut.
That was a nice right by Stevens, a little hook. Johnson coming right back at him, though.
Head's right in the center, though, Kenny. He's got to get his head off to one side. Good combination from Johnson. Beautiful.
Johnson continues to work hard and effective, going from body to head. And it's Johnson again here in the third round. Digging strong.
Digged a couple shots into the hip of Curtis Stevens. Veteran move. He did it on the other side where the referee wasn't. He sunk that in on the left side, and the referee still caught it. But it definitely caught Curtis on the hip. I don't think it was a low blow, though.
Referee Gary Rosado saying something to Johnson. They return. Coming up, Cunningham Mansoor in our main event. We have timeout. 7 seconds to go here in round three, scheduled for 10.
And this is an opportunity for Curtis to take a small breather. He's looking a little gassed. They're a little tired. And, you know, nice veteran move.
And here they go. Final seconds, third round. Very active for both men. Amir Mansoor, he talked about yesterday, he went to training camp for 3.5 weeks. That's rather long for him, he said, getting ready. That is the main event. Cunningham Mansoor coming up next. Back to live action, round four. This is scheduled for 10, and they go right back at it. Tureano Johnson is in the black with the turquoise. All three rounds to him, according to our own Larry Hazard, and a surprise Curtis Stevens, perhaps, the man who usually puts guys away by this time in a fight.
And I don't think we've seen Curtis Stevens lose hardly any rounds in the whole time he's been here, much less go rounds. So, you know, Tureano Johnson's got a great start to this fight. Curtis started to open up a little more in the last round, but Johnson is still controlling the pace in the terms of how this fight is fought, Kenny.
Well, except for Golovkin, you don't see this in too many of Curtis Stevens' fights where he is getting outpointed and out-power-punched as he is here by Johnson.
Johnson's smothering him. He's not giving Curtis any room to operate. Curtis is very, very heavy-handed, but he likes to do it on his terms. And Johnson's making him fight on his terms here.
And Johnson, with 2-3 nice rights in there, continues to aggravate, frustrate Stevens. Let's check in on this strategy now with Chris.
Guys, fighters don't always take strategy from other opponents, but you mentioned it, Kenny. Tureano Johnson is employing the exact same strategy we saw Gennady Golovkin do with Stevens last year. Golovkin was extremely effective pushing Stevens to the ropes where he clearly doesn't like to be and applying all the pressure. If Johnson can take Curtis's power like Golovkin did, it is a good strategy to win.
All right. Thank you, Chris, indeed. And Johnson is doing it quite masterfully here, actually, BJ, in this, the fourth round.
He's landed a lot of very nice short punches on the inside. He's digging body shots in there. He's hit Curtis with the short overhand rights, with the left uppercuts, with the cupping right hands. He's making the punches count when he throws them, and he's really punishing Curtis against those ropes, Kenny.
And again, a couple more. You see the power punches landed in favor of Johnson. Now Stevens gets active, and the crowd is on its feet.
Johnson's got to remember to move his head in there because Curtis is heavy-handed. And just because Curtis at times is going into a bit of a hibernation status, he can always come out of that with an explosive left hook. A nice right uppercut.
Uppercut by Stevens. And Stevens now getting Johnson in the corner.
Stevens turning the tide here a little bit. Johnson's a little arm-weary. And Stevens, big left hook by Stevens. Johnson's in trouble.
Stevens going trying to work on Johnson. Johnson withstanding it so far. A good left, another left by Stevens.
Stevens is looking for the opportunity. He was waiting it out. He was letting Johnson tire down just a little bit. And now he's really making Johnson pay in this round, Kenny.
And Stevens, by far his best round. His power punch is now landing.
Beautiful punch selection, uppercuts, left hooks. And Johnson's amazingly weathering the storm and fighting back, Kenny. Nice short right uppercut. Short right hooks from Johnson on the inside.
Johnson has taken the flurry of Stevens, and he's still standing.
Fight unbelievable round.
Round four.
Look at this. And we saw some tremendous action in the last round. Johnson was really pressing the pace, but Curtis started to find his range, letting combinations go, landed a big left hook to the temple right there, a couple other big left hooks, nice right uppercut, beautiful inside work from Curtis Stevens, and just a very game Tureano Johnson to be able to continue with that high pressure throughout that fourth round.
And Stevens landed some great punches on Johnson. You see a little bit of swelling over the right eye, but there was Johnson swinging away. And now here they come out for round five.
And now Johnson's coming out in the orthodox stance. The last three rounds he'd come out in the southpaw, this round orthodox. When you're in close though, Kenny, it doesn't matter too much.
And Johnson picks it right back up. Curtis Stevens getting the last round unofficially, according to Larry Hazard. Stevens landing 59% of his power punches in that last round, according to CompuBox.
Big right hand from Johnson there.
Right, indeed. There you see the power punches. Look at that, 64 power punches landed between them, 40 for Johnson in that last round. And then most of those power punches, Stevens landing up, but Johnson coming back strong late in that round.
And Johnson's already landed about 15 to 16 punches this round, and Curtis hasn't even thrown one. So he's got to stay at the pace at Johnson. He can't just continually wait and sit back because he's given away too many rounds. Now this is where Curtis wants to be. With Johnson's back against the ropes, he's got Johnson's head right in the middle. So he's got all of his punches that he can shoot. He can shoot the uppercut, the hook to the body. He's got everything when Johnson's right there in the middle.
Johnson, that was his 10th power punch. 10-0 right now he has Stevens in that department.
And Stevens landed some beautiful hard punches last round, and I gave him the round. But he might have punched himself out a bit, as it would appear. This is a beautiful right hook by Stevens.
The thing with Stevens, he's always a punch away from turning it around.
And both guys showing incredible toughness here, Kenny. Big right hand.
Look,
this is unbelievable.
They are toe-to-toe, slugging it out.
Nice right uppercut by Stevens.
Stevens coming back.
Johnson showing an unbelievable chin here, Kenny. How is he still up right now?
They're standing. The crowd's standing. What a show here in round five. Johnson has taken some great punches by Stevens in the last round and in this round, and he's come right back.
Unbelievable chin Johnson is showing, and he's continuing to come back and punish Curtis Stevens. Curtis is fighting in spurts, and when he does that, he's very effective. He's hurting Johnson, but Johnson is being more consistent and landing more punches throughout the round.
Johnson saying, it's my turn now to throw some along the ropes.
In the corner of Curtis Stevens saying, hey, tie him up. Don't let him continually pound on the body and pound on your arms like that, because Johnson's getting some good work done in there, Kenny.
Tureano Johnson came in with a game plan, and he has stuck to it. And he has taken some wicked shots from Curtis Stevens in the last two rounds, and now throwing some more of his own.
Nobody thought this fight would go out of the second or third round, Kenny. Tureano Johnson comes in with the amateur pedigree. He trained with the Cuban national team from 2003 to 2008, and he was at the Beijing Olympics in 2008. He's showing up tonight and having a great performance.
14-0, Tureano Johnson coming right back to end round five.
Tremendous action in the fifth round. Curtis Stevens, beautiful punch selection here. Uppercuts, left hooks, beautiful shots on the inside, really making Tureano Johnson pay. We got a fight breaking out in Philadelphia, Kenny.
Well, indeed we do. As we go into this sixth round, scheduled for 10, Tureano Johnson in the black with the turquoise, taking on Curtis Stevens in the blue and red. Stevens, more experience. Johnson, the Olympian that's undefeated as a pro. Johnson getting the last round, according to our own Larry Hazard. hazard. And here's a great stat from CompuBox in that last round. Stevens, no power punches in round in the first minute, 16 in the second minute. Let's check in the Stevens corner now with Chris Mannix.
Andre, the last few rounds, you've emphasized stay in the middle of the ring. What's he got to do that?
He just has to step around and move towards the center. That's all he needs to do.
You surprised Toriano's been able to put this much pressure on him?
Well, he's a tough kid, and he knows that's the only thing he can do. So he's doing what he can do.
At some point, do you have to start thinking about getting that knockout to win?
Not yet. It's kind of close. He's doing a lot of pressure, but he's getting hit with some big shots, too. So.
Thanks, Andre.
And even Gary Rosado having some trouble separating him there. And right back at it, here comes Johnson.
And Johnson's just doing tremendous work on the inside, Kenny. Very unorthodox combinations. Two, three right hands in a row. Cupping right hand, short uppercuts. Just very good work. And it's very difficult to see what's going on in there. But it's all about position. Who's got it, whose head where? You see Johnson trying to get his head off to the left side, to the right side. When his head is on that side, he's looking to land particular punches. And he's been very, very effective.
And Johnson pushing Stevens into the corner. And then goes right back to work. Total power punches landed. Johnson continues to have the edge. Stevens coming right back.
Even when Curtis spins off the ropes, it seems like Johnson puts him right back where he wants him. And, that's definitely playing into Johnson's advantage because Curtis has shown, hey, I can hurt you, Johnson, but Johnson's shown, listen, I'm not going to go out, and I'm going to come back and put you back against the ropes and punish you some more.
The thing with Curtis Stevens, like in the last round, he threw 21 power punches. 16 of those came in the second minute of that round. He has shown that in a moment he can turn it around and turn it on. Coming up next, it's Cunningham Mansoor. Heavyweights in a crucial showdown.
He's fighting in spurts, Kenny, is what he's doing. And Curtis has to not worry about landing the one punch on the knockout bomb. He's got to just stay on pace more with Tureano Johnson.
Final seconds, round six. Johnson continues to apply the pressure. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Between big men coming up in our main event. And now what has been a spectacular fight, Tureano Johnson, the undefeated 14-0 youngster from Nassau, Bahamas, taking on Curtis Stevens as we go into round seven.
You see Kurt continually shaking out his arms. That means his arms are a little heavy. He's got the lactic acid buildup in there, and he's trying to shake them out to see if he can, see if that'll help him to not have his arms not feel quite so tired. So it's an old trick. A lot of fighters try to do it, so.
And unofficially, Larry Hazard has every round but one going to Tureano Johnson.
And it's kind of hard to score not for Tureano Johnson. Whatever, he's been so active. He's been landing hard punches. He's been matching Curtis punch for punch. So it's been very difficult. You know, he's fighting like the guy who's losing the fight, Kenny.
And he goes to the body again. Misses just that much with an uppercut.
And Johnson reminds me kind of like a buzzsaw. He doesn't really stop punching. He's constantly coming forward. His punch selection is beautiful. And the only thing that I'd like to see Johnson do a little more is move his head after his punches because everything else is working pretty good. Now, Curtis needs to be careful here, not just to try to load up with one punch. He's definitely down on the scorecards, and he's not matching Johnson's hand speed, so he's got to try his best, though, to time Johnson on some of these punches to see if he can land something heavy and change the side of the fight.
Well, it's just impressive. These middleweights have been at this pace since the start of this fight, BJ. It's been each round, Curtis Stevens pacing himself a bit more, but Johnson has applied the pressure since the opening bell of this fight.
Curtis needs to sit back right now and look to land a good opportunity for a counterpunch.
And Johnson has shifted from southpaw to orthodox throughout this fight.
He's made it very difficult for Curtis to get a beat on him, Kenny. He hasn't been able to time his punches, and he's switching it up and giving Curtis different looks. So it's been very difficult. And you see, Johnson never looks to hold on the inside. He's in tremendous shape. He's always looking to let his hands go. Curtis is picking his spots a little more. He's effective when he punches, but I'm afraid the activity of Johnson is overwhelming Curtis right now. Nice right uppercut by Johnson on the inside.
Power punches thrown. Johnson more active by over 100 punches thrown than Stevens.
And Curtis has got such a good chin, and so does Johnson. Both guys are showing how game they are and how tough they really are. Who would have thought that Johnson could get hit with the amount of shots that he has and still be around here in round seven, Kenny? Beautiful body shot.
Curtis Stevens probably doesn't think so.
And now Curtis has switched to a southpaw stance.
First time we've seen Stevens go to southpaw.
Back to orthodox form.
Yeah, that was about four punches. Gets a good right in there.
But he landed a nice left hand off the ropes. And it's hard for Stevens to be offensive. Look at his feet. Both feet are together against the ropes. You can't get good leverage on the punches. Johnson advantage again.
And toe-to-toe is the way they're going to end this round.
BCSN and NBC.
Andre Rozier in the corner of Curtis Stevens, and another round unofficially scored by Larry for Tureano Johnson. All but one unofficially scored for Johnson in this fight, and the urgency now, they're telling Stevens, pay attention here, get into this. As we listen to him between rounds.
I agree. And you know what? The corner of Stevens told him, hey, listen, Johnson's slap boxing. I completely disagree. Johnson has taken Stevens to the rope. He's punished him. He's hit him with the body shots. He's hit him with the inside uppercuts. And he's fought a very effective game plan. Now Curtis has landed some good combinations of his own now. And this is what he should have been doing, Kenny, three and four rounds ago. Combinations off the ropes, not letting Johnson walk right in and punish him with body shots and hooks.
And again, Johnson goes to southpaw for this instant. We'll see how long he stays with that. Let's check in with Chris.
Antonio, Toriano's been putting relentless pressure on from start to finish. What are you seeing from him out there?
He's working hard. Curtis is definitely in good shape. Anticipated him breaking him down by now, but Reno's, we just gotta stick to the plan and keep trying to break him down. That's all we can do right now.
You wanna see him keep applying this pressure over these final few rounds?
Most definitely. He's gonna earn this for the end.
Thanks, Tony.
And you see Johnson.
Chris, yeah, it's working, isn't it?
Very undeterred. Nice shot from Johnson there. More punishing punches there. And just, you know, this looks like the type of fight that Johnson wanted. And I'm shocked. I can't believe it. I thought in order for him to have any chance, he was going to have to box early. And he came right out and fought the same game plan ever since round one, Kenny.
Big D, baby.
And he looks like the fresher fighter. And two reasons for that. The first one being that he has been making Curtis fight his fight. And secondly, maybe he was in a little better shape than we thought before this fight, Kenny.
Well, we know about that great amateur background that he had, the fact that he trained in Cuba, trained over there to qualify for the Olympics, representing his country of the Bahamas. He made the team in 2008, made it to the quarterfinals, so we knew about this extensive amateur background. Some question about the 14-0 pro record, as you'd have with any young fighter, but he is proving he is up for the task, as again, he takes the punches from Curtis Stevens.
And Curtis got a little arm weary after that combination there. Here's the thing, just because he's 14-0 doesn't mean he's necessarily good, but it doesn't mean he's bad either, and everyone said he hasn't fought anybody, and that's true, but that doesn't mean he can't fight, and we're seeing that tonight.
Stevens going to the body. Final seconds of round eight. The pace has not slowed down since the start of this fight.
Hard at. You're not fighting like you got
hard. Baby. Come on, man. Get up, man.
Hey, let's go, baby. You got to work these rounds. Just box him and turn him. Box him and turn him. Kurt, I don't understand why you're doing this. I really don't. This is for more.
All right.
It's for your son.
It's for everything, baby.
Let's go.
2-6 minutes left.
As much a revival type of inspiration as instructions in the corner of that last round for Stevens. Unofficially, Larry scoring that last round for Stevens.
Yeah, that last round, Curtis definitely had a lot more success with combination punching. But, you know, the corner of Curtis Stevens. Kurt, I don't know why you're not doing it. I don't know why. Listen, it's not so much what Kurt's not doing. It is, you got to give Tureano Johnson credit for what he's doing.
And Johnson, once again, is just walking right in. This is the way he started this fight.
But it's just amazing to me, Kenny, how he's been able to come right into the wheelhouse of Curtis. Not one, not two, not three rounds. Every single round, and force Curtis to fight his fight on the inside.
when you, Chris, and I were sitting there yesterday at the fighter meeting, and he said there's a lot of myth about these big knockouts that Stevens has early. The real key is you have to know how to fight him, and a guy that knows how to fight him is not going to get knocked out early. We all kind of looked at each other in a little disbelief, but he has shown it tonight.
You know, I'm not surprised. Any guy who goes to the Olympics, anybody who's been with the Cuban team, they know how to fight. So when he said he'd been over there 6 years, I was a little surprised that, you know, he'd spent the amount of time over there, that he went to the Olympics, that I still didn't really know who he was. But everybody is learning who Tureano Johnson is tonight.
30-year-old from Nassau, the Bahamas, has taken this fight to Curtis Stevens. And unofficially, we have him winning the majority of the rounds. He brought his entire family to the fighters' meetings, his dad, his mom, his sister, who is a coach for the Bahamian team, a neighbor who sang his praises, and it was a total love fest with the Johnson family at the fighter meeting. And I must say, Tureano Johnson was the best-dressed fighter to ever show up for one of the meetings. He had a sport coat on. He looked like he was ready for a night out.
He absolutely was. And one of my good friends, Andre Berto, also told me, listen, BJ, watch out for this guy, Tureano Johnson. I've had him in a couple of my camps, and he's a very tough kid. So, you know, definitely watch out. So maybe I got a little bit of a tip-off.
Well, Tureano Johnson is certainly ready for a big night out right now as Curtis Stevens trying to find an answer here. And none to be had at the moment with 20 seconds to go in the ninth round.
Another good round for Johnson. It's now to the point where Curtis Stevens needs a knockout to win, Kenny. You know, Johnson's bullying him around. He's pushing him around the ring. He's making him fight his fight. And not at all how Stevens wanted it to go tonight.
Stevens couldn't get the knockout in the first round. He will need one in this last round. And coming twice, the world cruiserweight title.
I know he's doing well.
The corner, Tureano Johnson.
He's in great shape.
Look at me, man. Look at me. Fire, baby. Come on, baby.
Shorten your shots up and step with your left foot. Don't square up. Stay in the A position.
Come on, this is for everything, guys.
This is it. Last round. They touch out of respect, and Curtis Stevens looks him in the eye this time. And right at it they go.
Now, if I'm the corner of Johnson here, I would want to tell him, hey, listen, you know, maybe let's not come quite so hard forward. We got this fight won. Let's take it. But obviously Johnson will have none of that. He's going to continue to fight the exact same way he has the whole fight.
Larry giving that last round as well to Tureano Johnson.
Yeah, you have to.
Johnson, you and Steve Cunningham breaking down the fight inside the ring. Predictions this would be an early evening perhaps for Johnson. Did anyone think it was going to be a 10th round fight for him?
Yeah, Steve predicted that it would be an early night, and I told a couple people, you know, Chris and a couple other, you know, guys that I work with, that, you know, this amateur background that Johnson has is a real background, a real pedigree. So, you know, I'm not going to be surprised if it gets out of the first three or four rounds. And I said, if it goes 10 rounds, Stevens could be in a bit of trouble because we haven't seen him go a lot of rounds. He's used to getting those guys out of there so early. So, but even with that being said, Kenny, it is very surprising. A few matchmakers told me, hey, Johnson's a live dog, and a couple guys that have had Johnson in camp have all said the same thing about him. He's very tough.
And look at him, walking right down, cutting off this ring and taking the fight to Stevens, just like he did at the start of the fight.
Back to southpaw stance here. And you know, Johnson, you know, he's up probably 7 or 8 rounds on the scorecards, but he's fighting like the fighter who's down right now, and that's what you like to see from an up-and-coming prospect. Curtis Stevens is a kind of a proven fighter, except for Gennady Golovkin. He's been very dominant with everybody he's faced over the last 2 years, and Tureano Johnson came out today, and he's really making a statement in front of a huge national audience, Kenny.
And Johnson made a statement yesterday.
There's the punch we're talking about. Johnson in a lot of trouble right here.
There's Stevens.
And the fight's over.
Stevens finishes it.
Oh, my gosh. Curtis Stevens down on the scorecards.
Where did that come
And all of a sudden, He lands the big left hook, the shot we were talking about, the big left hook that he needed.
Just around a minute to go, he charged at Johnson, and the ref stopped the fight. Johnson, in the 10th round, with an 11-hour TKO win, and Johnson cannot believe that the fight was stopped.
Wow. Look at the left hook. We were talking about it. Even in the 10th round, Curtis Johnson always carries that power. Curtis Stevens always carries that power. He lands the big left hook and gets Johnson in trouble. Rushing.
And look at Johnson. Curtis Stevens had been outpointed most of this fight. And then here, that left.
Beautiful left hook by Curtis Stevens. He hurt Tureano Johnson, got him against the ropes, and did what a trained fighter does. The referee stepped in a little early, in my opinion. Johnson looked like, you know, he was definitely hurt and shaken, but Curtis didn't land that big concussive punch and, make it a foregone conclusion the fight should have been stopped. He's still, still kind of aware of his senses right here.
And you can see almost immediately he's trying to tell Gary Rosado, you didn't just stop this. He took some big punches in the middle rounds and came right back, did Johnson. And Johnson, who had been in charge of this fight until the final minute of this fight, and Curtis Stevens comes on with a series of punches to win it with a TKO. Let's go to Joe and get the official time on the TKO win.
Boxing fans, the time, 2 minutes and 9 seconds of round number 10, your winner by TKO from Brownsville, Brooklyn, New York, Curtis Showtime Stevens.
A controversial TKO victory for Curtis Stevens. Here with less than a minute to go in this fight. A great fight, at times toe-to-toe for most of these 10 rounds, in a fight most people thought was being won by Tureano Johnson. We take a look now at our CompuBox total power punches. Johnson by 21 landing.
Back to orthodox form.
Yeah, that was about 4 punches. Gets a good right in there.
But he landed a nice left hand off the ropes. And it's hard for Stevens to be offensive. Look at his feet. Both feet are together against the ropes. You can't get good leverage on the punches. Johnson advantage again.
And toe-to-toe is the way they're going to end this round.
BCSN and NBC.
You got to pick it up. Get that jab. And work underneath.
He's right there. He's not even over.
Touch his belly. That's all he's doing. You're allowing it, though.
Andre Rozier in the corner of Curtis Stevens, and another round unofficially scored by Larry for Tureano Johnson. All but one unofficially scored for Johnson in this fight, and the urgency now, they're telling Stevens, pay attention here, get into this, as we listen to him between rounds.
I agree, and you know what? The corner of Stevens told him, hey, listen, Johnson's slap boxing. I completely disagree. Johnson has taken Stevens to the rope. He's punished him. He's hit him with the body shots. He's hit him with the inside uppercuts. And he's fought a very effective game plan. Now Curtis has landed some good combinations of his own now. And this is what he should have been doing, Kenny, 3 and 4 rounds ago. Combinations off the ropes. Not letting Johnson walk right in and punish him with body shots and hooks.
And again, Johnson goes to southpaw for this instant. We'll see how long he stays with that. Let's check in with Chris.
Antonio, Toriano's been putting relentless pressure on from start to finish. What are you seeing from him out there?
He's working hard. Curtis is definitely in good shape. Anticipated him breaking him down by now, but Reno's, we're just going to stick to the plan and keep trying to break him down. That's all we can do right now.
You want to see him keep applying this pressure over these final few rounds?
Most definitely. He's going to earn this for the end.
Thanks, Tony.
And you see Johnson.
Chris, yeah, it's working, isn't it?
Very undeterred. Nice shot from Johnson there. More punishing punches there. And just, you know, this looks like the type of fight that Johnson wanted. And I'm shocked. I can't believe it. I thought in order for him to have any chance, he was going to have to box early. And he came right out and fought the same game plan ever since round one, Kenny.
Big D, baby. There you go.
And he looks like the fresher fighter. And two reasons for that. The first one being that he has been making Curtis fight his fight. And secondly, maybe he was in a little better shape than we thought before this fight, Kenny.
Well, we know about that great amateur background that he had, the fact that he trained in Cuba, trained over there to qualify for the Olympics, representing his country of the Bahamas. He made the team in 2008, made it to the quarterfinals, so we knew about this extensive amateur background. Some question about the 14-0 pro record, as you'd have with any young fighter, but he is proving he is up for the task, as again, he takes the punches from Curtis Stevens.
And Curtis got a little arm weary after that combination there. Here's the thing, just because he's 14-0 doesn't mean he's necessarily good, but it doesn't mean he's bad either, and everyone said he hasn't fought anybody, and that's true, but that doesn't mean he can't fight, and we're seeing that tonight.
Stevens going to the body. Final seconds of round eight. The pace has not slowed down since the start of this fight.
Hard at. You're not fighting like you got hard.
Come on, man.
Right
now. Get up, man.
Get in, guys.
Right, let's go, baby.
You got to work these rounds. Just box him and turn him. Box him and turn him. Kurt, I don't understand why you're doing this. I really don't. It's like... this is for more.
All right.
It's for your son.
It's for everything, baby.
Let's go.
2-6 minutes left.
As much a revival type of inspiration as instructions in the corner of that last round for Stevens. Unofficially, Larry scoring that last round for Stevens.
Yeah, and that last round, Curtis definitely had a lot more success with combination punching. But, you know, the corner of Curtis Stevens. Kurt, I don't know why you're not doing it. I don't know why. Listen, it's not so much what Kurt's not doing. It is, you got to give Tureano Johnson credit for what he's doing.
And Johnson, once again, is just walking right in. This is the way he started this fight.
But it's just amazing to me, Kenny, how he's been able to come right into the wheelhouse of Curtis. Not one, not two, not three rounds. Every single round, and force Curtis to fight his fight on the inside.
When you, Chris, and I are sitting there yesterday at the fighter meeting, and he said there's a lot of myth about these big knockouts that Stevens has early. The real key is you have to know how to fight him, and a guy that knows how to fight him is not going to get knocked out early. We all kind of looked at each other in a little disbelief, but he has shown it tonight.
You know, I'm not surprised. Any guy who goes to the Olympics, anybody who's been with the Cuban team, they know how to fight. So when he said he'd been over there 6 years, I was a little surprised that, you know, he'd spent the amount of time over there, that he went to the Olympics, that I still didn't really know who he was. But everybody is learning who Tureano Johnson is tonight.
30-year-old from Nassau, the Bahamas, has taken this fight to Curtis Stevens. And unofficially, we have him winning the majority of the rounds. He brought his entire family to the fighters meetings, his dad, his mom, his sister, who is a coach for the Bahamian team, a neighbor who sang his praises, and it was a total love fest with the Johnson family at the fighter meeting. And I must say, Tureano Johnson was the best dressed fighter to ever show up for one of the meetings. He had a sport coat on. He looked like he was ready for a night out.
He absolutely was. And one of my good friends, Andre Berto, also told me, listen, BJ, watch out for this guy, Tureano Johnson. I've had him in a couple of my camps, and he's a very tough kid. So, you know, definitely watch out. So maybe I got a little bit of a tip off.
Well, Tureano Johnson is certainly ready for a big night out right now, as Curtis Stevens trying to find an answer here. And none to be had at the moment with 20 seconds to go in the ninth round.
Another good round for Johnson. It's now to the point where Curtis Stevens needs a knockout to win, Kenny. Got to be careful, but so far you got to see, like what you've seen out of the corner of Johnson.
Well, Johnson charged out the start of this fight showing southpaw, went back to orthodox, and continues to walk right at Curtis Stevens. Let's check in with Chris Mannix.
Antonio, Tureano promised yesterday he would come right out and stand and trade with Curtis. He's doing that so far. Why is that a good strategy for you guys?
Because he's in tip-top shape, and I made sure he was prepared to go for war.
He's trading shots with Curtis right now. Are you worried at all about his chin?
It's going to break him down. It's a matter of time. You're going to be surprised. He's going to stop Curtis. Give him about the seventh round.
Thanks, Tony.
Nice left hook by Curtis Stevens on the inside. You see, he's pretty patient. Oh, beautiful uppercut. as well.
Beautiful uppercut indeed by Stevens.
And with Stevens, he's got that one punch equalizer. He's got that power. Once he gets calmed down and relaxed, he can change the fight or end the fight at any time. So Johnson's doing well in this round. Yes, he won the last round, but Curtis has that one punch power. And, Johnson has to continue to be careful on those ropes. Keep his head off the center, not in the way of the Curtis Stevens uppercut.
Johnson landing more of the power punches in the early going of this round as he did in the first round. Trying to get an uppercut of his own and not able to. Remember, Johnson said at the fighter meeting yesterday, I'm not afraid of an early knockout. He said, actually, all this first-round knockout stuff about Stevens is, quote, a myth. It depends on who fights him and do they know how to fight him. So far, he knows how to fight him.
Johnson is smothering him. He's taking away some of the advantage of Curtis Stevens. And it's surprising that he's trying to physically bully Curtis Stevens inside a little bit. He's pushing him back. Kenny.
Johnson has turned into Curtis Stevens right now.
He really has, and you know, the thing that he's doing so well is he's making Curtis uncomfortable. He's hitting Curtis in the body, he's hitting him with shots. I think Curtis expected to be in full control at this stage in the fight, and Johnson to be on the retreat.
Johnson continues to be active. Nice right as he slides it over the glove.
Big right hand by Johnson inside.
Right again by Johnson. Johnson showing his own power here in the first two rounds.
And it's hard for Curtis to be too offensive with both feet square together. He needs to get one foot in front of the other one so he can get good leverage on his punches. Very difficult round for Curtis Stevens again.
Final seconds, round two.
Where do I want you to stay? Why are you on the road today?
Yo, Curtis.
Don't try to catch this.
Work. It'll come. Andre Rozier in the corner of Curtis Stevens between rounds. Stevens a little bit surprised and confused, perhaps, that Tureano Johnson, the undefeated young pro from the Bahamas, has taken the fight to him in the first two rounds.
Kenny, I'm confused. I'm shocked that he came out like that and he's able to bully him in the ropes like that. The corner of Stevens is saying, hey, get in the middle of the ring. But Johnson is cutting it off very effectively, and more of the same from Curtis.
Stevens now trying to work back.
Big left hook by Stevens, but Johnson undeterred. Johnson's showing he's very rough.
Body shot by Johnson.
And big right uppercut counter. Beautiful shot by Curtis Stevens with his back on the ropes right there.
These two guys, neither backing down.
Curtis has got to be careful not to give away too many of those body shots early, Kenny. This is the second or third round, and the corner of Stevens is already saying, you're giving away too many body shots. That'll wear him down the stretch.
And coming back to the body again is Tureano Johnson. Larry Hazard giving
Johnson on the inside. Beautiful punch selection inside. You know, when you're in that close, it doesn't look like there's a lot of punches you can land. But Toriano's picking the punches that he can land, and he's got Stevens a little bit of trouble here, Kenny.
He slid a nice uppercut in just a few moments ago.
I can't believe the pace of Johnson here. He's pretending like this is a four-round fight.
Johnson has been at a frenetic pace since the start of this fight.
And now Curtis switched the momentum a little bit. He's back in Tureano into the ropes. And hopefully he'll go back into the middle of the ring here. Nice short left uppercut
again.
Nice counter left uppercut by Curtis Stevens.
Stevens coming back on Johnson, but Johnson continues to actually be more aggressive in this third round, BJ. He is not slowing down.
He's not. We saw him very confident in the fighter meetings yesterday, Kenny, and now we see why. Good punch by Curtis Stevens, and Curtis starting to loosen up now with his back against the ropes. Johnson's got to be very careful to get his head off the center when he's inside with Curtis Stevens, because Curtis Stevens got that very effective right uppercut.
That was a nice right by Stevens, a little hook. Johnson coming right back at him, though.
Head's right in the center, though, Kenny. He's got to get his head off to one side. Good combination from Johnson. Beautiful.
Johnson continues to work hard and effective, going from body to head. And it hits Johnson again here in the third round. Still digging strong.
Digged a couple shots into the hip of Curtis Stevens. Veteran move. He did it on the other side where the referee wasn't. He sunk that in on the left side, and the referee still caught it, but it definitely caught Curtis on the hip. I don't think it was a low blow, though.
Referee Gary Rosato saying something to Johnson. They return. Coming up, Cunningham Mansoor in our main event. We have timeout, 7 seconds to go here in round three, scheduled for 10.
And this is an opportunity for Curtis to take a small breather. He's looking a little gassed there, a little tired, and you know, nice veteran move.
And here they go. Final seconds, third round. Very active for both men. Amir Mansoor, he talked about yesterday, he went to training camp for 3.5 weeks. That's rather long.
Nobody thought this fight would go out of the second or third round, Kenny. Tureano Johnson comes in with the amateur pedigree. He trained with the Cuban national team from 2003 to 2008, and he was at the Beijing Olympics in 2008. He's showing up tonight and having a great performance.
14-0, Tureano Johnson coming right back to end round five.
Tremendous action in the fifth round. Curtis Stevens, beautiful punch selection here. Uppercuts, left hooks, beautiful shots on the inside, really making Tureano Johnson pay. We got a fight breaking out in Philadelphia, Kenny.
Well, indeed we do. As we go into this sixth round, scheduled for 10, Tureano Johnson in the black with the turquoise, taking on Curtis Stevens in the blue and red. Stevens, more experience. Johnson, the Olympian that's undefeated as a pro. Johnson getting the last round, according to our own Larry Hazard. And here's a great stat from CompuBox in that last round. Stevens, no power punches in round in the first minute, 16 in the second minute. Let's check in the Stevens corner now with Chris Mannix.
Andre, the last few rounds, you've emphasized stay in the middle of the ring. What's he got to do that?
He just has to step around and move towards the center. That's all he needs to do.
You surprised Toriano's been able to put this much pressure on him?
Well, he's a tough kid, and he knows that's the only thing he can do. So he's doing what he can do.
At some point, do you have to start thinking about getting that knockout to win?
Not yet. It's kind of close. He's doing a lot of pressure, but he's getting hit with some big shots, too. So.
Thanks, Andre.
And even Gary Rosato having some trouble separating them there. And right back at it, here comes Johnson.
And Johnson's just doing tremendous work on the inside, Kenny. Very unorthodox combinations. 2-3 right hands in a row. Cupping right hand, short uppercuts. Just very good work. And it's very difficult to see what's going on in there. But it's all about position. Who's got it, whose head where? You see Johnson trying to get his head off to the left side, to the right side. When his head is on that side, he's looking to land particular punches. And he's been very, very effective.
And Johnson pushing Stevens into the corner. And then goes right back to work. Total power punches landed. Johnson continues to have the edge. Stevens coming right back.
Even when Curtis spins off the ropes, it seems like Johnson puts him right back where he wants him. And, you know, that's definitely playing into Johnson's advantage because Curtis has shown, hey, I can hurt you, Johnson, but Johnson's shown, listen, I'm not going to go out, and I'm going to come back and put you back against the ropes and punish you some more.
The thing with Curtis Stevens, like in the last round, he threw 21 power punches. 16 of those came in the second minute of that round. He has shown that in a moment he can turn it around and turn it on. Coming up next, it's Cunningham Mansoor. Heavyweights in a crucial showdown.
He's fighting in spurts, Kenny, is what he's doing. And Curtis has to not worry about landing the one punch and the knockout bomb. He's got to just stay on pace more with Tureano Johnson.
Final seconds, round six. Johnson continues to apply the pressure. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Between big men coming up in our main event. And now what has been a spectacular fight, Tureano Johnson, the undefeated 14-0 youngster from Nassau, Bahamas, taking on Curtis Stevens as we go into round seven.
You see Kurt continually shaking out his arms. That means his arms are a little heavy. He's got the lactic acid buildup in there, and he's trying to shake them out to see if he can, you know, see if that'll help him to not have his arms not feel quite so tired. So it's an old trick. A lot of fighters try to do it, so.
And unofficially, Larry Hazard has every round but one going to Tureano Johnson.
And it's kind of hard to score not for Tureano Johnson. Whatever, he's been so active. He's been landing hard punches. He's been matching Curtis punch for punch. So it's been very difficult.
You know, he's fighting like the guy who's losing the fight, Kenny.
And he goes to the body again. Misses just that much with an uppercut.
And Johnson reminds me kind of like a buzzsaw. He doesn't really stop punching. He's constantly coming forward. His punch selection is beautiful. And the only thing that I'd like to see Johnson do a little more is move his head after his punches, because everything else is working pretty good. Now, Curtis needs to be careful here, not just to try to load up with one punch. He's definitely down on the scorecards, and he's not matching Johnson's hand speed, so he's got to try his best, though, to time Johnson on some of these punches to see if he can land something heavy and change the side of the fight.
It's just impressive. These middleweights have been at this pace since the start of this fight, BJ. It's been each round, Curtis Stevens pacing himself a bit more, but Johnson has applied the pressure since the opening bell of this fight.
Curtis needs to sit back right now and look to land a good opportunity for a counterpunch.
And Johnson has shifted from southpaw to orthodox throughout this fight.
He's made it very difficult for Curtis to get a beat on him, Kenny. He hasn't been able to time his punches, and he's switching it up and giving Curtis different looks. So it's been very difficult. And you see, Johnson never looks to hold on the inside. He's in tremendous shape. He's always looking to let his hands go. Curtis is picking his spots a little more. He's effective when he punches, but I'm afraid the activity of Johnson is overwhelming Curtis right now. Nice right uppercut by Johnson on the inside.
Power punches thrown. Johnson more active by over 100 punches thrown than Stevens.
And Curtis has got such a good chin, and so does Johnson. Both guys are showing how game they are and how tough they really are. Who would have thought that Johnson could get hit with the amount of shots that he has and still be around here in round seven, Kenny? Beautiful body shot.
Curtis Stevens probably doesn't think so.
And now Curtis has switched to a southpaw stance.
First time we've seen Stevens go to southpaw. For him, he said, getting ready. That is the main event. Cunningham Mansour coming up next. Back to live action. Round four. This is scheduled for 10, and they go right back at it. Tureano Johnson is in the black with the turquoise. All three rounds to him, according to our own Larry Hazard. And a surprise, Curtis Stevens, perhaps, the man who usually puts guys away by this time in a fight.
And I don't think we've seen Curtis Stevens lose hardly any rounds in the whole time he's been here, much less go rounds. So, you know, Tureano Johnson's got a great start to this fight. Curtis started to open up a little more in the last round, but Johnson is still controlling the pace in the terms of how this fight is fought, Kenny.
Well, except for Golovkin, you don't see this in too many of Curtis Stevens' fights, where he is getting outpointed and out-power-punched as he is here by Johnson.
Johnson's smothering him. He's not giving Curtis any room to operate. Curtis is very, very heavy-handed, but he likes to do it on his terms, and Johnson's making him fight on his terms here.
And Johnson, with two, three nice rights in there, continues to aggravate, frustrate Stevens. Let's check in on this strategy now with Chris.
Guys, fighters don't always take strategy from other opponents, but you mentioned it, Kenny. Tureano Johnson is employing the exact same strategy we saw Gennady Golovkin do with Stevens last year. Golovkin was extremely effective pushing Stevens to the ropes, where he clearly doesn't like to be, and applying all the pressure. If Johnson can take Curtis's power like Golovkin did, it is a good strategy to win.
All right, thank you, Chris, indeed. And Johnson is doing it quite masterfully here, actually, BJ, in this, the fourth round.
He's landed a lot of very nice short punches on the inside. He's digging body shots in there. He's hit Curtis with the short overhand rights, with the left uppercuts, with the cupping right hands. He's making the punches count when he throws them, and he's really punishing Curtis against those ropes, Kenny.
And again, a couple more. You see the power punches landed in favor of Johnson. Now Stevens gets active, and the crowd is on its feet.
Johnson's got to remember to move his head in there, because Curtis is heavy-handed. And just because Curtis at times is going into a bit of a hibernation status, he can always come out of that with an explosive left hook. A nice right uppercut.
Uppercut by Stevens. And Stevens now getting Johnson in the corner.
Stevens turning the tide here a little bit. Johnson's a little arm-weary. And Stevens, big left hook by Stevens. Johnson's in trouble.
Here. Stevens going to work on Johnson. Johnson withstanding it so far. A good left.
Stevens was looking for the opportunity. He was waiting it out. He was letting Johnson tire down just a little bit. And now he's really making Johnson pay in this round, Kenny.
And Stevens, by far his best round. His power punch is now landing.
Beautiful punch selection, uppercuts, left hooks. And Johnson's amazingly weathering the storm and fighting back, Kenny. Nice short right uppercut. Short right hooks from Johnson on the inside.
Johnson has taken the flurry of Stevens, and he's still standing.
Unbelievable round. Look at this.
Right around, fighting all the way to the bell.
saw some tremendous action in the last round. Johnson was really pressing the pace, but Curtis started to find his range, letting combinations go, landed a big left hook to the temple right there, a couple other big left hooks, nice right uppercut, beautiful inside work from Curtis Stevens, and just a very game Tureano Johnson to be able to continue with that high pressure throughout that fourth round.
And Stevens landed some great punches on Johnson. You see a little bit of swelling over the right eye, but there was Johnson swinging away. And now here they come out for round five.
And now Johnson's coming out in the orthodox stance. The last three rounds, he'd come out in the southpaw, this round orthodox. When you're in close, though, Kenny, it doesn't matter too much.
And Johnson picks it right back up. Curtis Stevens getting the last round unofficially, according to Larry Hazard. Stevens landing 59% of his power punches in that last round, according to CompuBox.
Big right hand from Johnson there.
Right, indeed. There you see the power punches. Look at that, 64 power punches landed between them, 40 for Johnson in that last round. And then most of those power punches, Stevens landing up, but Johnson coming back strong late in that round.
And Johnson's already landed about 15 to 16 punches this round, and Curtis hasn't even thrown one. So he's got to stay at the pace at Johnson. He can't just continually wait and sit back because he's given away too many rounds. Now this is where Curtis wants to be. With Johnson's back against the ropes, he's got Johnson's head right in the middle. So he's got all of his punches that he can shoot. He can shoot the uppercut, the hook to the body. He's got everything when Johnson's right there in the middle.
Johnson, that was his 10th power punch. 10-0 right now he has Stevens in that department.
And Stevens landed some beautiful hard punches last round, and I gave him the round. But he might have punched himself out a bit, as it would appear. This is a beautiful right hook by Stevens.
The thing with Stevens, he's always a punch away from turning it around.
And both guys showing incredible toughness here, Kenny. Big right hand.
Look,
this is unbelievable.
They are toe-to-toe, slugging it out.
Nice right uppercut by Stevens.
Stevens coming back.
Johnson showing an unbelievable chin here, Kenny. How is he still up right now?
They're standing. The crowd's standing. What a show here in round five. Johnson has taken some great punches by Stevens in the last round and in this round, and he's come right back.
Unbelievable chin Johnson is showing, and he's continuing to come back and punish Curtis Stevens. Curtis is fighting in spurts, and when he does that, he's very effective. He's hurting Johnson, but Johnson is being more consistent and landing more punches throughout the round.
Johnson saying, it's my turn now to throw some along the ropes.
In the corner of Curtis Stevens saying, hey, tie him up. Don't let him continually pound on the body and pound on your arms like that, because Johnson's getting some good work done in there, Kenny.
Tureano Johnson came in with a game plan, and he has stuck to it. And he has taken some wicked shots from Curtis Stevens in the last two rounds, and now throwing some more of his own.
Tonight's bouts is sanctioned by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. Commissioners at ringside, Joel Frank and Rudy Battle. Our executive director is Greg Serb. Physicians at ringside, Dr. George Stolsteimer, Dr. Bert Blackstone, and Dr. Paul Steinberg. And our timekeeper at the bell, Jim Mina. Boxing fans, here we go. Our co-main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing in the middleweight division. Our judges, Pierre Benoist, David Braslow, John Potteray, and our co-main event referee, Gary Rosado. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he comes to us tonight from the beautiful Nassau in the Bahamas. He weighed in at 162 pounds, black trunks, aqua trim. Professional record, a perfect 14 victories, no defeats, 10 of his wins coming by knockout. Please welcome former Olympian, Tureano Reno Johnson. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he comes to us tonight from Brownsville, Brooklyn. He weighed in at 162 and three quarter pounds. Black, blue, red trunks, professional record, 26 victories, only four defeats, 19 of his wins by knockout. Please welcome Curtis Showtime Stevens. referee Gary Rosato has our fighters' final instructions.
Detailed instructions in the locker morning, I'll tell you two things. Protect yourselves at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves, bang at the bell. All
right. 10 rounds. Middleweights.
Stevens trying to get in the head of Johnson. A little touch of the gloves there, but no look into the eyes. We'll see if he can get in close to Johnson. And Johnson, how legit is this power? 10 of his 14 wins coming by way of knockout, 7 of those in the first 2 rounds.
I don't think it's a question of the power of Johnson. And you see Johnson comes out in the southpaw stance. Look at that right there. Nice start. And he's got to be careful not to get in the wheelhouse of Curtis Stevens too early. Good
and
shots
Johnson's
by Johnson.
Coming right at him, trying to work the body of Stevens. Johnson said he was going to do this. He's living up to it right now, said he had no fear.
The wrong strategy for Johnson here. He looks very tight, very compact on the inside, but this is the wrong strategy for Johnson, I'm telling you.
Few men have tried this in the early going. Johnson is trying to go toe-to-toe with Stevens.
Makes for an entertaining fight the while last, Kenny. I don't think this one's going too long.
Well, the southpaw Johnson, his biggest pro fight. And he has taken it to Curtis Stevens. Let's check in with Chris.
Andre, Johnson's coming right at him. Is this what you want to see?
Actually, yeah, because eventually he'll touch him enough to get him out of there.
How's Curtis's condition coming to this fight? Only fought one round in his last one.
Oh, he's ready to work. He's ready to work.
Thanks, Andre.
Nice short right uppercut inside by Johnson. And Stevens a little surprised that Johnson came at him like this. He really is. And Johnson's defense, very compact. He's got him nice and tight on the ropes, keeping everything in close. Curtis caught him with a couple nice hooks, but Johnson's still there, Kenny.
Johnson with that great amateur experience. Stevens with good amateur experience himself. He has the third most knockouts in New York amateur history. Power punches landed so far, and they have been landed frequently.
Nice left hook by Stevens there.
Stevens now counters, going to the body.
And Johnson's got to move his head if he's going to sit inside with Curtis like that. Curtis also has a very good right uppercut. You see it right there, digging that into the body. That could be a very effective punch.
Oh, good lefts by Curtis Stevens in close.
And I'm very surprised that Johnson decided to come right out and take Curtis Stevens to the ropes like that. He puts himself in danger, but he's also landing some decent shots in there, Kenny. Nice right uppercut by Johnson.
Slides in 2 uppercuts. Tureano Johnson said he was ready to bring it. It depended on the kind of fighter who could fight in close. So far, so good for him. Over 2 minutes into this fight.
Johnson's back into the orthodox stance now. He came out southpaw, though. And look at him trying to take the fight to Curtis, really walking him down, using good head movement. Curtis very relaxed against the ropes there, shooting good punches, catching a lot of the Johnson punches on his gloves. But Johnson's done some good work, Kenny. Very surprising.
BJ, southpaw or orthodox, has been an aggressive Tureano Johnson here in this first round.
And he's got nice, short, compact punches in there, Kenny. That's the thing that's saving him. He's able to match Curtis Stevens punch for punch because he's not wasting a lot of energy and he's not wasting a lot of space on those punches. They're not looping punches. They're nice and short. Big left hook by Stevens.
Johnson is able to get through the first round and look good doing so. You can join in on the action at home on Twitter for a chance to win prizes from tonight's fight. Just follow at NBCSN on Twitter. Well, it was an interesting first round. Tureano Johnson in the black with the turquoise trim coming right at Curtis Stevens, and he's doing the same here as we start round 2.
Johnson
Larry
landed.
Hazard is unofficially scoring it for us, and he gave that first round.
And Johnson comes right back out in the second round trying to apply more pressure. He's still got to be careful. Curtis Stevens has a very heavy left hand, and when he's in that southpaw stance, he's very vulnerable to that left hook in close. So.